We're asked to consider the sum 3 plus 9 plus 15 plus 21 plus dot 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 plus 723. Part A, how many terms or summons are in the sum? And part B, we're asked to compute the sum using a technique discussed in this section. To begin, let's let the first term be a sub 0. To begin, let's let the first term be a sub 0. A sub 0 is equal to 3. And then from here, analyzing the sum, notice how the terms are increasing by 6. 3 plus 6 is 9, 9 plus 6 is 15, and so on. And therefore, we have a sum of an arithmetic sequence, or an arithmetic series, where the common difference d is equal to 6. Another way to check for a common difference is to use the formula d equals a sub n minus a sub n minus 1, which means we can find the common difference d by selecting any term except the first term and subtracting the term before it. Notice 21 minus 15 is 6, 15 minus 9 is 6, and so on. Now, before we can determine how many terms are in the sum, we need to determine the closed formula for the sequence we are summing. And because the first term is a sub 0, the closed formula is a sub n equals a sub 0 plus d times n. Which means in our case, a sub n is equal to 3 plus 6n. And now to work on determining how many terms we have, we will substitute 723 for a sub n and then solve for n. This gives us the equation 723 equals 3 plus 6n. And now we solve for n. We first subtract 3 on both sides, which gives us 720 equals 6n. And then we divide both sides by 6. Simplifying, we have n equals 120. Because the first term is a sub 0, this does not mean we have 120 terms. But we do know the first term is a sub 0, and now the last term is a sub 120, which means there are 121 terms in the sum. If the first term was a sub 1, and the last term was a sub 120, there would be 120 terms. But again, there's one more term because the first term is a sub 0. So again, the sum has 121 terms. And now we want to find the sum using a technique discussed in the section. So instead of using the formula below, we will first write out the sum and set it equal to s. We have s equals 3 plus 9 plus 15 plus 21 plus dot dot dot. The last term is 723, but let's get the last two terms. The term before 723 is going to be 6 less, or 717. So we have plus 717 plus 723. Again, notice 717 plus 6 is 723. And now we're going to write the sum again in reverse order. So we have s equals 723 plus 717 plus a bunch more terms, where now the last two terms are going to be plus 9 plus 3. And now we're going to go ahead and add these two equations together. On the left, we have s plus s, which is 2s, equals on the right, 3 plus 723 is 726, plus, notice 9 plus 717 is also 726, plus we have a whole bunch more sums, but notice all these sums are 726. So the question is, how many 726s are we summing? Well, we know there are 121 terms in the sum, and therefore we have a sum of 121 726s, which means you can write this as 2s equals 121 times 726. And now to solve for s and determine the sum, we divide by 2. Simplifying, we have s equals 121 times 726 is 87,846, giving us 87,846 divided by 2, which is 43,923. The sum of the given arithmetic sequence is 43,923. I hope you found this helpful.